course, it is possible to develop a rather sentimental feeling about nature. After all, we're losing nature at an alarming rate, with species becoming extinct and just general destruction that we're wreaking all over the planet. But there is a better way of relating to nature than with sentimentality and sadness, and that is respect. You know, look at how nature bursts through concrete, given the chance. If we were all gone from here, Mother Nature would reclaim this whole place a lot more quickly than perhaps we realize. So respect is the order of the day here. And if you think about it also, think about how much of our lives is supported by nature, much more than we tend to think, because we think about the stuff that we make and the technology and so on, and we forget how much of that is only replicating things that already exist in nature. And let me give you an example. Here's a cell phone. A few years ago, only very, very wealthy people had these, but now almost everyone, certainly in the West, has one. Imagine coming across one of these if you came from a time and a place when no such thing existed. What is it? It's a little box. If we took it apart, we might find that it's full of components. We may learn that it has a battery inside it, and the battery is supplying power, that it can do things like take pictures and record sounds. We wouldn't necessarily straight away realize that it's capable of communicating with cell phone towers which are scattered around these mountains, and certainly wouldn't necessarily realize that this little box will enable us to speak, enable me to speak to someone on the other side of the world just by pressing a few buttons and paying some money. So first of all, it's not obvious that it has a power source. And looking inside it, you cannot see necessarily how much power is stored in it. It's only when you actually try and use it, you start it up, you find out if it has any power and perhaps how much power it has. So this is rather similar with the human organism, that how much energy is stored inside the organism is not obvious by looking at it. It's not completely obvious. But the energy that's stored inside it comes from plugging it in physically to something. In the same way, the energy that's stored inside us comes from us being plugged in to our environment. We're breathing the air, we live in an environment filled with air, with many gases, and we nourish ourselves with those. We nourish ourselves with things that we draw straight from the environment. And then there's the less obvious thing, which is the way that this object connects with distant cell towers and other telephones across the planet. Now, how many times has it happened to you that the thought of a person comes into your mind, someone you haven't seen for maybe 15, 20 years, and you think, oh yeah, thinking about that person. And then, 5 minutes later, the phone rings, and it's that person. Now, what made you think of them? Most people have experienced this. What made you think of them before the telephone call? We don't know, but it may have been the intention to call you that that person felt before they made the call that reached you. We are transceivers. A transceiver is something which transmits and receives, and we are transceiving all the time. You walk into a room where there's been an argument, you feel the atmosphere, you pick up on it, straight away you sense there's something wrong, you're receiving. You give off energy fields, you give off feelings according to your thoughts and feelings, which affect other people around you. So we are transceivers. There are many ways we can make use of the fact that we are transceivers once we acknowledge that as the case. But if we get ourselves stuck in a belief that it is not possible to communicate directly without the use of one of these, then we won't try. So we won't be able to do it. Or it might happen to us by accident and we might never do it again. To take a skeptical approach, we have to say, I suspend disbelief. I don't know what is and what isn't possible, so I'm going to pay attention to what happens and find out what can be done, what is possible, by observing my direct experience.